Emotional eating, food and emotions. Tell me what you eat and I will tell you what psychological problems you have. People are addicted to different foods. Some people are addicted to chocolate, others are addicted to chips, some are addicted to nuts. Although nuts are considered to be a healthy snack, those people can eat lots of them and get more calories than they need. Today we will find the connection between the food we eat and our emotions. Analyzing the food that we like can help us to identify the emotions that we're trying to suppress. Food helps us to manage our emotions. Depending on the type of food, sweets, french fries, chips, salty food, or crispy food, you can learn different things about yourself. The goal of today's webinar is to teach you how to understand your eating behavior and why you eat more than you need. Today we will talk about cakes, burgers, chicken wings, nuts, chips, chocolates, mostly unhealthy food. And we will discuss how this type of food is related to our emotions. We're gonna talk about anger, loneliness, sadness, boredom, hidden aggression, lack of love, anxiety, and positive emotions such as joy and excitement. Hi guys, my name is Elena Semenek and this is my YouTube channel, Psychology of Happiness. On this channel, I teach you about happiness, about money, about health, about food, about self-esteem. I teach you how to become happier and more successful in life. If you'd like this channel, if you'd like today's topic, please give me thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Also, below the video, you can find links to my Facebook and to my Instagram account. Every week, I release new videos here on YouTube and share them on my other social networks. Please join me. Let's move on and start today's webinar, Emotional Eating. Tell me what you eat and they tell you what psychological problems you have. As you know, excess weight is associated with metabolism. The main purpose of metabolism is to convert or transform food to energy. Our emotions work the same way. When we receive information of any kind, we have some type of emotional reaction to that information. It can be sudden or it can be strong. If we don't express our emotions, if we don't reflect on our emotions, then we suppress them with food. People who cannot express their feelings, who do not talk about their emotions, within time are more likely to develop an eating addiction. Have you heard about psychosomatic disorder or psychosomatic illness? To put it simple, psychosomatic medicine deals with how our daily problems affect our health. People who do not address their psychological aspects of their life often develop physical ailments, high blood pressure, knee problems, diabetes, all types of eating disorder, heart problems, etc. Therefore, let's practice right now. Let's learn how to increase our emotional metabolism. Let's connect and identify our emotions, our reactions, and most importantly, instead of suppressing them with food, let's release them. So I encourage you to write about your feelings and emotions in the chat along with this webinar. Ask your questions, post your comments, share your emotions, use emojis. The first question to you, where are you watching me from? What is your city and country? The second question, why do you want to lose weight? Have you tried to lose weight before? And what result were you able to achieve? Please write the answers to those questions in the comment section of this video. Today I will teach you how being aware of what you eat can help you to identify which emotions or feelings or psychological problems you're trying to suppress. So let's talk more about emotional eating. Our emotions and feelings make our life brighter, more diverse, and more interesting. In order for us to feel that we are alive, we have to connect with our emotions. They can be bad or good, but they should be vivid. Example, couples can fight all the time and get on each other's nerves, but still be together. This happens because those fights make them feel something. They have to fight to defend their opinions. They have to fight to get what they want. Often those partners can say that this is their style of communication. They're not fighting, this is just the way they talk. People come to my private session saying that they want to feel more fun and joy in their life. They often say that something is missing in their life. Elderly people can die earlier because of the feelings of loneliness. They may have a lack of motivation in their life. They may have lost many people close to them. Extreme boredom can actually cause us physical harm. I believe that my grandmother would have lived longer if she had hobbies, interests, or good friends. Food also gives us energy. Food also brings us a vast variety of emotions because of the diverse combinations of flavor. We are affected differently by different foods. When we eat sour food, our lips pucker. When we eat spicy food, we feel a warm sensation inside. When we eat fatty foods or sweets, we smile because we feel joy. One dish can combine several flavors simultaneously. Our brain gets excited by those combinations. For example, ice cream is cold and sweet. We can also add fruits, nuts, and chocolates into it and overwhelm our brain with pleasure. Another example is Thai food. It has a variety of spices and flavors. A third example is cheeseburger. Soft buns, juicy meat, fresh tomatoes, melted cheese, ketchup or mayo, and crunchy pickles on a side. Just think about how many flavors can exist in just one bite of a burger. Let's add french fries, glass of wine, and a nice atmosphere at home or in a bar, music, or a movie on TV. You can't possibly feel sad or lonely when we have all those components. You are content while you are chewing your burger. When we finish eating, our real emotions return, and we reach for the bag of chips or a beer so we can suppress them again. Food is an excellent substitute for our emotions.